Alhamdulillah. Assalamu alaikum, my brothers and sisters. I'm on my way home from Nigeria, but there is something very important I need to discuss. So even though I'm quite tired, I would like to discuss the topic of suicide. Recently, I've been getting so many emails from boys and girls, young, saying, I'm fed up of life, my parents are making life difficult, they're not allowing me to marry who I want, they're not allowing me to do something, they're being harsh, hard, some are abused by their parents, some have so many other difficulties, so much is happening, and people around them are making their lives very, very difficult, whether it's brothers, sisters, in-laws, spouse, children sometimes, parents in a lot of cases, making their lives difficult. And so these people become suicidal because they feel that they've reached the end of the road or there is no purpose to live. Now, we can address this from many angles, but I want to address it from one or two angles tonight, and I don't want to lengthen this live session. The first thing is, my brothers and sisters, it's never the end of the road. You need to know that just like when the night becomes darker and darker and darker, and after the darkest part of the night, there is a sudden daybreak. Allah has promised you that there will be that daybreak. You know, things begin to get better, but Allah will test you up to the limit. So turn to Allah. Praise Him, read the Quran, engage in the remembrance of Allah, fulfill your salah, fall in love with Allah, help those who are in worse conditions than you are, thank Allah for the little bit that you have, and appreciate the favors of Allah upon you. Start helping others, and your doors will begin to open bit by bit. You will see the light. That's number one. But number two, more importantly, I want to address all of us. The way we treat people. Why do parents refuse their children from marrying people that they want to marry, who are reasonable? If they're not from your tribe, they're not your nationality, they're not, for example, your race, it doesn't mean you have to reject them. People use Islam to suit themselves and to blackmail their children or the others into believing that it is religiously wrong. That's not true. That is not true. If your deen, your akhlaq, meaning your level of consciousness of the Almighty and your character and conduct is similar, then you know what? If you have been brought up in a similar way, the person is similar. Today, on a global level, we find people the same nationality. They went to the same schools, the same universities, they have the same norms, but because they're from different ethnicities, they actually do not allow their children to marry a different ethnicity, and they use Islam saying, no, we are not kufu. Kufu meaning we're not similar, the similarities, it's not gonna work. Do you know what? Well, your child went to school with these people or this person, or met them and have grown up in a very, very similar way, so much so that perhaps they are more kufu to the person they want to marry than to you as a father and a mother, because you belong to a totally different generation and totally different norms. Wow. So my beloved brothers and sisters, let's make life easy for one another. People are, you know, I don't know how many may have committed suicide already, because nobody's going to email me to say I've already killed myself. But we get so many emails. It's scary. We cannot reply them messages to say, you know what? I don't think there's any reason to live. My beloved children and those who think the road has ended, I've already addressed that. But for those of us who have people around us, you're a brother, you're a wife, you're a husband, please behave yourself. Please behave yourself. Please treat your spouses with respect. Make life easy. The Almighty will make life easy for you. Don't make life difficult for others. You leave them stranded. You leave them hanging. You leave them without food and clothing. You wait for them to get evicted from their homes. And you are supposed to be a guardian. You wait for them to actually suffer on earth. And you are supposed to be there. You know, the children of your deceased brother or sister, wallahi, they are a blessing unto you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An opportunity to score goals, to be able to earn reward. So let's make life easy for people. Let's actually help people, because if you are to save one life, it's as though you have saved entire humanity. Allah says, وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا kullama ahya an-nasa jami'a, when you have saved one soul, one person, Muslim, non-Muslim, whoever it may be, those you agree with, those you don't, those you like, those you dislike, if you have saved a single soul, it is as though you have saved entire humanity. When we talk of that verse, we always refer to physical abuse and perhaps physically saving someone. But I want to say, if you saved someone from committing suicide, you have indeed saved entire humanity. And if you are the one who has caused that person's suicidal thoughts, then you are a criminal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. So please, for the sake of Allah, learn to help people, learn to make things easy for others. Don't be hard and fast. We're living in an age where you cannot be harsh, you cannot be hard on your children and on those whom you live with. You've got to be easygoing. People will make mistakes. Allow them to make mistakes. Nobody's perfect. So if they make a mistake, you can correct the mistake. Imagine Allah Himself says, I love those tawabin. Inna Allah yuhibbul tawabin. Allah loves the tawabin. Have you ever thought of what that means? It means those who keep repenting. In order to repent, I need to be a sinful person. If I was not sinful, what was the point of repenting? So Allah also says, you committed the sin. I love those who keep on correcting themselves, coming back to me. They made a sin, they came back to me. They made another one, they came back to me. They made the same one again, they came back to me. That is what Allah says He loves, because they've recognized that He is the owner. He is the creator, nourisher, cherisher, sustainer, provider, protector, forgiver. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah is saying, I love those who seek forgiveness, it means within that statement, He also loves those who make the mistake and realize. We don't even want our kids to make a mistake, or anyone around us. We don't want them to make mistakes at all. And if they do, it's like doom. That's it. Their lives are an end, have come to an end. Come on, if the Almighty had to treat us that way, all our lives would have been coming to an end, or have come to an end a long time back. So I want to tell you, please look at your please have mercy on those whom you live with. Have mercy on those around you. We must open the doors for people. We must make sure that they lead their lives. It's not your life, it's their lives. I cannot make decisions for my adult children when I have already made my own decisions at that age. I look at fathers sometimes, and at the age of 20-25, they made their own decisions. They went to live in other countries. They did whatever they wanted. Nobody was there to tell them. But their children at the age of 40 and 50, they want to control the child. And how many times you will kiss your wife is controlled by your father. Come on. Or by your mother. A'udhu billah. How can that be? Why should they have such a big say in your independent home? And then they blackmail you by saying, but you know, heaven lies by serving us. Or at times they say under the feet. It's not actually under the feet, but it's by serving them. So yes, we will serve, we will be kind, but we don't have to obey you when you are talking rubbish, nonsense, utter unacceptable words, unacceptable instructions. I mean, you're not a little god besides Allah. A'udhu billah. Come on, my beloved parents. Let's smell the coffee. You can tell your children, but you need to know the decisions are theirs. They are responsible in the eyes of Allah. So teach them when they are young and then leave them to do their thing. When kids get married, let them do their thing. Come on. Don't keep interfering. What to cook, what not to cook. You must come here. You must massage my feet. You must cook this. You must bring it here. We've got visitors. You must come. You must sit. You must do that. The visitors came to visit you, not to all of us here. Subhanallah. So may Allah open the doors. You can see how passionate I am. We want to save people from committing suicide, from being suicidal. And there's no point in screaming and yelling at one another and becoming physical, becoming abusive, because wallahi, people become depressed. But together with that, let's learn to sacrifice as well. MashaAllah. With sacrifice for one another, we will attain the pleasure of Allah. So my brothers, my sisters, I'm extremely tired. I'm actually in transit in Ethiopia, subhanallah, and I'll be leaving this place. And I loved Nigeria. I learned a lot from it, subhanallah. And I always learn. I always meet people who make me feel, subhanallah, that you know what, I actually have a lot more to do. And I've seen people who are more knowledgeable, who are doing hard work, who are, you know, higher in so many different ways, and they inspire me in so many different ways. Wallahi. And I'm always touched. This is why I want to do another video at some stage, speaking about the fact that we're not the only Muslims. Across the globe, there are people trying to earn the pleasure of Allah. in the most remote places of the globe. And subhanallah, we are busy thinking that we are the Muslims, we are pious, we read salah, we wear our hijab, not realizing that the hijabs we wear sometimes are actually not the ideal, and none of us are ideal. But that struggle we have, and we still feel we're better than some others. Let's not think that way. My brothers, my sisters, I love you for the sake of Allah. We're all in this boat together. We're all trying to earn Jannah. I'd love to see everyone in Jannatul Firdaus. Who am I to remove people from Jannah and say, you're not going there? It's the ownership of Allah. May Allah, the Almighty, the most merciful, the most loving, the most kind, the most forgiving, the most compassionate, subhanallah, may He grant all of us forgiveness and mercy and Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you can spread this far and wide. I'll be posting it on YouTube, Mufti Menk YouTube channel. Inshallah, if you subscribe to that and you actually put on your notifications, you'll be able to get that. And if you spread it to others, you earn a great reward. This topic has been very important. I've kept it short, sweet, to the point, and extremely passionate because, wallahi, it's coming from the heart. If you can't feel that, there's something wrong with your heart. Don't get upset with what I've said. If you are getting upset, you're guilty. That's why you're getting upset. But if you're happy and excited, perhaps you're a victim. Sometimes you're happy and excited, you're a victim and you're guilty. It's possible for someone to be a victim in one crime and a criminal in another. So be careful, my brothers and sisters. May Allah strengthen us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I don't feel like going, but I have to go. Assalamu alaikum.